Hi, it's Carrie. I'm the Health Professions Librarian at Towson University's Albert S. Cook Library. In this video, I'm going to discuss why critical appraisal of research evidence is important and how you can become more confident at critical appraisal. Critical appraisal of primary and secondary research evidence can help you assess its validity, relevance, reliability, and quality. Asking the right questions, like what was the research question? Did the authors choose appropriate inclusion criteria? Did they use a sufficient literature search strategy? Is there a chance of publication or other bias? And are the recommendations supported by the data? Can help you identify flaws in the publication's methodology, identify potential biases, and make sense of the results. It is possible, after all, that the results of a study or expert review may be due to the way that it was designed and carried out, and not necessarily a reflection of the whole truth. The wonderful thing is that while you need to ask the right questions, you don't need to come up with them yourself. There are a couple of different sets of critical appraisal checklists. These checklists can help you ask the right questions as you look at the study or publication to assess its quality. I'm going to outline a few of my favorite checklist collections. I'll put links to them in the video description so that you can access them when you need them. Let's say you've done some evidence-based literature searching in PubMed. I have a video for this if you need help. Okay, so you've done some searching and you've located a couple of systematic reviews on your topic. You want to critically appraise them, but where to start? One of my favorites is the JBI Critical Appraisal Tools. This is one of the most comprehensive sets of checklists available. You'll find checklists for systematic reviews and randomized controlled trials, but also economic evaluations, case series, qualitative research, and even text and opinion. Let's look at their systematic review checklist. We'll scroll down and we'll see the questions we need to answer. In this case, there are 11, and they range from helping you identify the question to judging the appropriateness of the search strategy to investigating the methods of synthesizing data. In the subsequent pages, you'll see a narrative with guidance for each question. This can help you understand what to look for. I am also a big fan of the CASP, the Critical Appraisal Skills Program. CASP contains checklists for systematic reviews, randomized controlled trials, clinical prediction rules, and a few more. Let's take a look again at the systematic review checklist. The CASP checklist for systematic reviews asks questions that are similar to JBI, prompting you to identify the research question, judge the inclusion criteria for included studies, understand if all important outcomes were considered, and decide if the benefit of the intervention is worth the harms and costs. Last but not least, let's look at the checklists available from the Center for Evidence-Based Medicine from the University of Oxford. Here, you can find critical appraisal checklists for systematic reviews, randomized controlled trials, and more. Each sheet will guide you on what to look for and what is considered a best practice. Let's look at the systematic review sheet. It will ask you to determine the question that the review intends to answer. If you believe that any studies may have been missed, which you can deduce from looking at the methods section of the paper, if the inclusion criteria were appropriate, and more. There is one more tool that may help you to critically appraise evidence. This tool is not a critical appraisal checklist collection, but a collection of guidelines that can help you understand how a specific type of publication should be reported. For that, you can visit the EQUATOR Network and look at the reporting guidelines for each type of publication or study. This will help you identify if your evidence is missing key information. Again, let's look at the guidelines for systematic reviews. The reporting guideline is called PRISMA, the Preferred Reporting Items for systematic reviews and meta-analyses. You'll be able to take a look at PRISMA and see what the authors should have reported in their publication, and then you can see if they did. If you would like to take a deeper dive into this topic, see if your library has the User's Guide to the Medical Literature by Gordon Guyot et al., published by JAMA Evidence and McGraw-Hill. You can find it as an ebook at the Cook Library by searching for it in our catalog. I hope that you were able to learn something new from this video. Leave a comment down below, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you find it helpful. Librarians are here to help, and I would be thrilled to hear from you.